Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to St. Anne's. We are pleased that you have chosen to worship with us in imitation of the Lord Jesus. We value and respect your life with all its richness and beautiful variety. May you find a home in this faith community. And a special welcome to all who are visitors and those watching from home. Today we celebrate the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We will hear that God watches over the prophet Jeremiah and over Jesus. Jeremiah is rescued and Jesus is raised from the dead. May their example help us to avoid growing weary and losing heart when we struggle to carry out our mission. Our Mass intention is for our parish community of St. Anne. Our celebrant is Father Ray. Please silence your cell phones, and I invite you to stand and greet those around you.
Great for us to be in this place that the Lord has gathered us together, invited us to come to share in worship and in love in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the great communion that is promised as a gift of the Holy Spirit, rest always with you.
And with your spirit.
And sisters and brothers, today's readings will remind us of the reality of division in our world and our need to be unified in our faith. Let us include today then a prayer for unity that comes from God. And as we begin, let us ask for God's healing and forgiveness for the times that we may have caused division in our life, that God has not been with us. O Lord Jesus, you came to set the world on fire. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you draw us. like you did Jeremiah out of the pit of destruction. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have taken your seat at the right hand of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God, in great love then, forgive all of our sins. This night fill us with the spirit of peace and bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. Prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see. Fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In those days, the princes said to the king, "Jeremiah ought to be put to death. He is demoralizing the soldiers who are left in the city and all the people by speaking such things to them. He is not interested in the welfare of our people, but in their ruin." King Zebadiah answered, "He is in your power, for the king could do nothing with them." And so they took Jeremiah and threw him into the cistern of Prince Malachi, which was in the quarters of the guard. Letting him down with ropes, there was no water in the cistern, only mud, and Jeremiah sank into the mud. Ebed-Melech, a court official, went there from the palace and said to him, "My lord king, these men have done at fault, and all they have done to the prophet Jeremiah, casting him into the cistern. He will die of famine on the spot, for there is no food in the city." Then the king ordered Ebed-Melech, the Cushite, to take three men along with him, and draw the prophet Jeremiah out of the cistern before he should die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us rid ourselves of every burden and sin that clings to us, and persevere in running the race that lies before us, while keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus, the leader and perfecter of faith. For the sake of joy that lay before him, he endured the cross, despising its shame, and has taken his seat at the right of the throne of God. Consider how he endured such opposition from sinners, in order that you may not grow weary and lose heart. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding blood. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
This night, our gospel is the good news for us according to Luke. Glory be to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, I have come to set the earth on fire, and how I wish it were already blazing. There is a baptism with which I must be baptized, and how great is my anguish until it is accomplished. Do you think that I have come to establish peace on the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two and two against three. A father will be divided against his son, and a son against his father. A mother against her daughter, and a daughter against her mother. A mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I want to start off by giving you a little history lesson about the time when this church, St. Anne's, caught on fire. It was just around 30 years ago this year that Life Team set this church ablaze. Some of you may remember it. I know the one who was instrumental in bringing this blaze about in our community is here tonight, Randy Rouse. Randy, could you stand up? I want to thank you, Randy, for being the fire starter, for giving us the opportunity to get excited about the faith that teenagers hold. Because what happened 30 years ago brought renewal to our prayer and our worship and our life here as a parish community. Shortly after Randy helped to set the church ablaze, he brought Ed. And Ed and the music ministry has kept that flame going up until today. And we are truly a great community of worship because of that. Spiritual renewal has happened, not only for you as teens, but also for the whole community in retreats that have been part of your life, part of Life Teen's life over the last 30 years. Life nights that have been beautifully, wonderfully, creatively prepared and you participated in. There's been excitement over these 30 years about the spiritual journeys that so many, not only you, teens, but your parents and your grandparents and other adults in our family of faith have experienced. Life Teen has created a core of caring people to accompany you, the teens, but also to increase the growth of their own faith and a greater closeness to Christ. Life Teen spun off a vibrant Edge middle school ministry and prepared with creativity and commitment thousands, think about it, over 30 years, thousands of our youth for the sacrament of confirmation. Any of you here were confirmed yesterday? If you are, could you stand? Hopefully, you have been prepared to set a fire with God's Spirit the places where you live, the schools that you go to. Life Teen has helped evolve mission trips and service projects so that the passion and energy of you, our teen community, could be offered to serve Christ, especially in his most vulnerable and weak, and to enjoy doing so. This blazing Life Teen fire also brought out Parents for Life. It brought that wonderful ministry to birth, where your parents wanted to share in the joy and the love and the excitement and the enthusiasm of not just watching you grow in faith, but growing in their faith alongside you. It engendered spiritual journeys and retreats and caring fundraisers and so many things that have helped our parent community, our families, to stay close to Christ and each other. And this Life Teen flame, I think, also has attracted and led many guests, many visitors, many newcomers. I hear it often. I've come to church here because of Life Teen. It has been an attractive force of bringing new members into our community. Some who are even watching us tonight all over the country and guess what? Worldwide. 30 years ago, Christ set ablaze life at St. Anne's, and we have not stopped burning since. And we've been burning brightly with the passion of so many caring and creative people. Second reading talks about, from Hebrews, a cloud of witnesses. We have a cloud of witnesses to the power of the faith of teens in our life and in our family. Randy himself, Ed and Karen Bolduc, Chris Benzinger, Mark Mayer, Pam Tong, Chris Turner, Megan Kyle, Ryan Cottrell, just to name a few of those who are the cloud of witnesses that have believed in you these 30 years to set you ablaze with faith in Christ. Now, I've left two people specifically out, but they are not left out. Let me tell you why. If I can do this without falling on my face. I'll let Michael do it. 4 years before this place was set ablaze by Life Teen's arrival. Can I have Joanne and Kelly come? Before the arrival of Life Teen to set this place ablaze. Randy, you and Randy received from a font like this and a paschal candle like this, a baptismal candle like this. And the prayer was prayed. First, Kelly, receive the light of Christ. Parents, we said to you and your godparents, this light and the light inside of her is to be kept burning brightly. For this child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as a child of the light. Keep the flame of faith alive in her heart. And that you have done. Because in the 4 years before Life Teen arrived, I'm convinced that God was preparing you for well over 12 years of ministry to the teens of not only this community, but of many communities around the country. You have brought your creativity, your enthusiasm, your passion for the faith of teens into their lives. And in doing so, you've hopefully set them ablaze. Wherever they've gone from here, in work and in school beyond, to stay close to Christ and to find within themselves the flame of faith that they could pass on to each other. I want you to once again pass that flame on to Kelly. Now, it doesn't end there, because no, you stay here. Because, Kelly, oh well, the best laid plans of mice and men. Because, Kelly, you again have not only kept that flame to yourself, you've shared that flame of passion and enthusiasm and support and encouragement and caring for the teens to so many other people. And we're gonna mention one of them tonight who's your, and I don't, you can never be replaced, your successor in the ministry, Jill Orban. Jill, will you come up? And now, Jill, that flame is passed to you. You don't burn it, don't you? That flame is passed to you to once again pass on to our teen community. And I want you to do that representatively. I'm going to hold yours, and I want you to pass it to the two people in the front pews and the end. You are representatives. No, one on each side. On each side. One on each side. You represent the teen community here that is set ablaze, I hope. And I pray to continue this wonderful journey of ours to keep our community alive and active in the faith, to bring your concern and your care and your passion and your love for the faith that you are receiving and sharing in and growing in through LifeTeen with others, not only here in the church, in Nolan Hall, but all out, once you go out. Because we've created opportunities for you to do that with mission trips and service projects and Bible studies and et cetera, all the things that you're going to be receiving again over the years to come. 30 years ago, this church was set on fire. 30 years later, it's still burning and blazing brightly for the Lord. And I guess I want to paraphrase him by saying, you know, I have come to set the church on fire, and how grateful I am that it is blazing as brightly as it is here at St. Anne's. Now, the last thing, Kelly and Joe, I want you, teen community, the teens especially, to stand. And you're going to come to the center of the altar. And we're going to give them a blessing. Please share your... Oh, good and gracious God, we thank you for the passion, the love, the faith which Kelly and Jill bring to the ministry of LifeTeen, the ministry of drawing teens closer to Christ. We thank you for the many blessings that they have been to others over the years that they have worked. We ask you to bless Kelly in the new adventures ahead. May she continue to bring your compassion, your caring, your love, your excitement, your enthusiasm for the faith and its living out into whatever works you call her to do for teens and young adults in the years ahead. I ask you especially too now to bless Jill as she takes up the mantle of Director of Youth Ministry, that too she will share her faith enthusiastically, lovingly, carefully with our teens, inspiring them to share it with each other and all those that they know will need the power and the strength of their faith. We ask you to bless them both, keep them safe in your love, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Stay standing and let us together profess the faith that we hold so dear. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus the Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again.
Trusting that God watches over us through all our trials and difficulties, we turn to God as we make our plea for mercy and hope. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis and all bishops and all of us that comprise our church, that we may persevere in running the race while keeping our eyes fixed on our Savior and Redeemer, we pray. That nations may see divisions and disagreements as opportunities for honest and constructive dialogue for the benefit of all and for peace in our world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the incarcerated, especially those unjustly sentenced, that they may hold fast to the love of Christ, seeking one day to gain their freedom and lead productive and affirming lives, we pray. That families who are divided may find comfort and peace in the embrace of an all-merciful God as they cope with strained relationships and estranged family members, we pray. For all those recovering from natural disasters, that God will comfort them in their loss, heal their injury, and open the hearts of many to be generous to them, we pray. For our teens and adults who receive the sacrament of confirmation Saturday, may their hearts be open to your Spirit, and may they bring to fulfillment the good works that you have begun in them. We pray. For the sick, the needy, the aged, and the lonely, that they be consoled spiritually by the gifts of grace and receive care, aid, and loving concern from relatives, friends, and neighbors. And for Doug Burns, Art DeCicero, Bill Downs, Joseph Fulicello, Jeff Giles, Elaine Johnson, Barbara Kinsley, Rusty Medlin, Joe Mirabal, Jonathan Moody, Rick Nemec, Nick Nicolosi, Evelyn Peterson, Bruce Tagg, and David Teed, we pray.
Prayer.
For those who have died, that they may find abundant joy in the promise of heaven, and for Jack Dodder, husband of Sharon, John Harrell, brother of Jim Harrell, uncle of Leslie Pistone, Dorothy McDonald, mother of Maura Tapley, grandmother of Aaron, Rachel, and Hillary, Bill Stout, brother-in-law of Linda Devlin, and for the intention of this Mass, our parish community of St. Anne, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Continuing then as a La Salette parish to seek the Blessed Mother's intercession for our needs and our community, we pray, Our Lady of La Salette, reconciler of sinners, pray without ceasing for us to have recourse to you. And God of all goodness, watch over and protect us as we stumble and fall, leading us always onward to your kingdom. Hear the prayers we make today, and grant them in your time and way, through your Son, who sits at your right hand, Jesus our Lord, now and forever. Amen.
This weekend's second collection is for St. Anne's Georgia Bulletin subscriptions.
Sisters and brothers, pray with me now that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to our almighty and loving God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given to us, we may merit to receive your very self through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you our thanks, Father of mercies, faithful God. For you have given us your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners. And he became a neighbor to the oppressed and to the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your daughters and sons. So now with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
And to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, Jesus Christ, present in our midst when we are gathered together by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens up the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth the power of your Spirit. Sanctify these gifts of bread and wine so that they may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving you thanks. He handed it to his disciples and he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. It is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Holy Father, as we celebrate now the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have now seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer to you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. So look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we now show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Archbishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and with the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our sisters and brothers. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth, freedom, peace, and justice, so that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give to them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. For there, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Our Lady of La Salette, with the apostles and martyrs, Saint Anne, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. For it is through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, that all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Life and the love of God in our own hearts.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day
in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress. As we await now the blessed hope, the second coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
The kingdom. Thank you.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you. My peace is my gift to you. Look not on our sins now, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant the peace, unity, hope of your kingdom, where you live, reign, and love us forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the risen and living Lord then be always with you. Please share that gift. Behold the Lamb of God, Jesus the Christ, who sets the world ablaze through our faith. We are blessed, called to share in the meal of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Before we have our closing prayer tonight, I believe Jill has some special announcements.
Thank you, Father Ray, especially for your beautiful words earlier tonight. But I just need to be very clear that where's Kelly? Because you may have passed the flame on to me, but your number's still on speed dial. So just know that, like, you're not off the hook just yet. When Kelly announced that she was resigning her position, I know that it sent a huge shockwave to this community, not just to the Life Teen community, but to the entire parish because of the number of lives that she has touched, the teens, the parents, all of us, really. And so sometimes we just don't have the words, and thank you is never enough. So we're just going to try and say thank you with some food and invite all of you to a reception immediately following this Mass in Nolan Hall, just so that we can say our thank yous, express our gratitude, and well wishes to Kelly. So please join us, everyone, in Nolan Hall immediately following Mass. And I have some special speakers who would like to say something as well.
Hi, my name is Crystal Norris. As president of the Life Teen Parent Board, and on behalf of thousands of parents of Life Teen members over the past 12 years, I would like to thank Kelly for all she's done for this program. On a personal note, only one day after my family moved to Georgia in July of 2018, Kelly met our rising freshman daughter in the lobby before Life Teen Mass and invited her to sit with her teens. Attending that life night was the best decision we ever made, as it shaped our daughter's entire high school experience and kept God in our life. Kelly has done something similar for so many of our teens. She not only led life nights, mission trips, retreats, and Bible studies. She attended games, recitals, plays, proms, escape rooms. Invite her if you go, she'll come. Halloween parties, Friendsgivings, bonfires, met for coffee, and much, much more. But even more importantly, Kelly was just a phone call away for any of the teens at any time of day. Whether she got a call in the middle of the night or from a kid crying at school in the bathroom, she was there. Her countless hours devoted to our teens will never be forgotten. Kelly, we will miss you tremendously, but are so incredibly excited for what's to come for you. We'd like for you to come up here again and accept this gift we collected on behalf of the Corps and Parent Board as a small token of our appreciation. Thank you so much for everything you've done for us.
For those of you I don't know, my name is Lauren Salarulo. I've been on Life Teen Corps for the past 5 years. So, Kelly, over the past 12 years, you've made an impact on the lives of thousands of teen, corps, and families of this parish. Thank you could never be enough. I'm so proud of you and always will be. It's been a joy to be your friend and watch you dedicate your whole life to teenagers, especially making sure that they know they are worthy and loved and have a place in this world and in heaven. I've had the honor of collecting pictures, notes, and videos from former and current teens and core members saying thank you for what you've done in their lives. I also have this box for you that is filled to the top of cards and notes expressing thanks and gratitude for the gift that you are to many. I also have a video compilation to send to you from teens saying thank you. Even though this might be your worst nightmare, being the center of attention, it's not over yet. I've created this video of some of the memories you've had at this parish over the past 12 years that we will all now watch together.
New ride. trying to catch a bird in flight. I knew that I would never touch, but now I won't let go, 'cause I'm happy to call this home. No more running, I'm good knowing that I belong.
Happy to call this home.
I've got love inside this side that can't come knows.
Happy to call this home. Oh, oh, oh.
Happy to call this. Shedding all that insecurity, I kind of found a new.
Open your heart, let Jesus in. Open your soul, let the freedom begin.
My worst nightmare. So something you may not know about me, I'm introverted. So when it's about them, it's really easy. When it's about me, I hate it so much. I have written and rewritten and thought and had an extremely long 4 months to think about how to even encompass what this parish and this community means to me. And there are truly no words to even begin to express my gratitude for not only you, the teens, and the tons of alumni are in this room. And I cannot thank you enough for what you've done for me, what you've done for this parish, and what you will have done for teens for years to come. Because you have no idea the mountains that you have moved, the things that you have done in my life, the way that you have made and helped me grow my own faith. I was 21 when I joined CORE and 22 when I was hired. And I want to thank Father Tom for believing in me, but I don't know what he was thinking because I just, to this day, have no idea who I was then. And there are now alumni who are older than what I was when I started in youth ministry. I've been to baptisms, weddings, everything. And it is such a joy to see the fruits of just what God has done in the vineyard and all the things that he has put into this. I had someone ask me yesterday at confirmation how many confirmations I had done, and I had to do the math, and it was 26. And then he kept asking, well, how many retreats or how many of this? And so I did the math. I've done 26 confirmation retreats. That's 26 Bring Me to Life skits. Yes. I've done 47 retreats, not including confirmation, between spring, fall, eighth grade retreat, 15 conferences, 27 mission trips. I thought about Life Night's Edge, all of those things. My brain started to hurt how many that there would be. And none of that matters. Like, none of it. I would do it all again for just one kid. I would. Because you have no idea how much you mean to me. And that, I pretty much, my entire 20s was spent here, and I wouldn't trade it for the world. It's very weird, my friends tell me it every day. But I wouldn't change it, because you have every day gotten me closer to heaven. And I look forward to a lot of things. That's probably the most common question people have asked me, like, what do you look forward to? And I look forward to my due job. I look forward to pouring into youth ministers, college kids, teens. I look forward to seeing where this program continues to grow. Most importantly, I look forward to heaven, because if you've never hung out with these teens before, heaven is going to be a blast. And the amount of whipped cream and milk and paint and just gross things, glitter, string cheese is a recent one, all these things that have been in my hair, all over me, on my car, I hope that follows me, which is the weirdest thing. I really hope it does.
And between all of those games and plays and late night parking lot conversations, which by the way, parents, I found out I've been used as a scapegoat many times of your children saying, I'm talking to Kelly, I'll be home soon. That's not necessarily true. So please don't believe that. I wouldn't keep your children here willingly by 11 p.m. at night. But thank you, parents, for just entrusting this parish, this program, this community, for entrusting me with your kids. Thank you to Father Ray. I know that both of us didn't sign up to do ministry in a pandemic, but I couldn't think of anyone better to do that with than you. So thank you for your leadership. To all those that preceded before me, to Randy for just planting those roots, to Greg Trainer for just having the will to go and the motivation to say that he wanted something different, he wanted something more. To Chris for, I love working with my best friend. It was really hard at times and really great too. And to Megan and Ryan these past couple years, just everything, I cannot express my gratitude. To Ed and all the crazy, weird things, not as bad as Chris did, but I had some other requests too, that we made you do, to the core, because it literally would not be possible. There's just no way it would be possible without you, whether you're a current core or you were on core for 3 months, or you were one of those core member couples that got on core and then had a child, you're welcome, because it happens all the time. So if you want to join core, please, please do. To my mother, who in my own stubbornness has believed in me and raised me and loves me for who I am, even though she can't hear anything that I say, but that's okay. To Jim for being one of the people who just believed in me and trusted me in everything that I did. I cannot express my greatness enough. I really can't. I am sure that I am forgetting hundreds and thousands of other people, because that's how many people have impacted me. Thank you, just the parishioners, for just hearing my voice every week. I'm sure that was really fun for you. And just believing in this community and believing in these teens and investing in this parish and this program. And teens, I cannot thank you enough, whether you are 13 or whether, I think the oldest now is 28. I've encountered over 3,500 teenagers, and with that, every single one of you has a place in my heart. Whether you were the most active kid and you're here every single day, whether you have been here once or you haven't been back since confirmation, like, you have a huge place in my heart and a place in heaven that is just waiting for you. I want to end with this quote I heard a couple months ago. It was from a TV show, and I don't watch a lot of TV, actually. So this was interesting that I came across this. It says, the way I see it, if something makes you sad when it ends, it must have been pretty wonderful when it was happening. Truth be told, I always felt it a bit lazy to just think of the world as sad, because so much of it is. Because everything ends, everything dies. But if you step back, and look at the whole picture, if you're brave enough to allow yourself the gift of a really wide perspective, if you do that, you'll see that the end is not sad. It's just the start of the next incredibly beautiful thing. Thank you again for everything you have done for me. This parish is my home. I'm not moving. I'll be around. And I hope to continue just leading this parish and walking a journey with you closer to heaven. So thank you.
God has Kelly designing the t-shirts for heaven. They'll be on sale. Let us pray in thanksgiving. Made partakers of Christ's through these sacraments, we humbly ask your mercy, O Lord, that conformed to his image here on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one loving God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And in God's great love, may we continue then to find our blessing, grace, courage, and peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
With our Eucharist ended, let us go renewed in faith to set the world on fire. Thanks be to God.
With every little